Good morning, myself Manoj Bhavaskar. Today we will see how, what is the application of profile projector. Now see, the profile projector can be used for linear measurement as well as for angular measurement. Now let us see how it is used to take the reading with the help of linear measurement. It consists two micrometer. One, you can see the shadow of this is object. I am interested to find out the diameter of this circle. Now how can I measure the diameter of this circle? We have two micrometers. If I move this micrometer in a clockwise direction, you can see the shadow is coming downwards, and if I rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, you can see the shadow is moving upwards. Now this is for longitudinal, or you can see, sorry, this is for cross movement of your shadow, and this micrometer is for lateral movement of your shadow. If I rotate it in clockwise direction, you can see the shadow is moving towards right hand side, and if I rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, you can see the shadow is moving towards left hand side. So this micrometer has 50 divisions, and main scale reading is 0.5. so 0.5 divided 50, the least count of this micrometer, or if for profile projector, is 0.01 mm, or you can say 10 microns. And you can measure angular measuring instrument. This is circle. This circle is divided into 360 divisions. So the least count of this circle is 1 degree. And if you see, 1 degree is divided into 12 divisions, or you can see 60 minutes. 60 minutes are divided into 12 divisions. So 1 division corresponds to 5 minutes. So least count for angular measurement of profile projector is 5 minutes. Now we'll see, in part one, we'll find out how to measure the linear dimensions by using profile projector. Before that, there are two lenses which magnifies your image, 10x and 20x. You can magnify your image, okay? You can minimize or maximize the concentration of light on the screen. Now let us start the experiment. Now this is the threaded plug gauge. I want to measure the major diameter of this threaded plug gauge. For that, you can see there are two cross lines. One is dotted cross line and other one is dark cross line. So dotted cross line is fixed line and dark cross line is moving line. You can see like this. So I'm using this phenomena or this line for measurement of major diameter. Now how to measure the major diameter of threaded plug gauge? You can see what I did. I have arranged this plug gauge in such a way that this dark line is tangent to the crest. Now I have to use this. Now what I did, I have taken the initial reading. I'll take the initial reading. Now the initial reading is 12.5. Then what I am going to do is I'll take this distance. This is a major diameter, distance between two crest, successive crest. See, this is 2.5. So initial reading was 2.5 and final reading was, sorry, initial reading was 12.5 and final reading was 2.5. So my diameter is 10. So major, I can say major diameter is 10 mm. So likewise, you can measure the minor diameter. Now what I'm going to do, I'm making this line tangent, dark line tangent to the root, or you can say valley, which will pass through the all valleys. Then I'll take again initial reading. Initial reading is 3.5. now then what I'm going to do, same thing. This tangent to the all roots, the line should be tangent to the all roots. And I'll take the final reading.
and initial final reading, and final reading minus initial reading is your minor diameter, you can say. You can measure the minor diameter. Now we'll see how to measure the pitch of the thread. The pitch of the thread, I have to use simple thing. See what I am going to do. Pitch means what? If I want to measure, see, pitch means what? The success distance between two successive points, either that point lies on the crest or that point lies on the root. So now I have considered this point of the crest. Okay, this point of the crest, and this point is corresponding point on the next thread is this point. So I'll measure this distance between this two point, and that is nothing but the pitch. Now initial reading is what I have to note. Initial reading is 20 on micrometer. Now here, see what I did, the distance between this point and this point. Okay, that is the crest. So that is nothing but pitch, you can say. So 22. So initial reading was this, and final reading on the micrometer is this one. So 22 minus 2 is 2. Your 2 mm is the pitch, you can say. So in this way you can measure the linear dimensions. Next video, part 2, we'll see how to measure the angular dimension by using floating carrying micrometer. Thank you.